This tutorial is going to show you how to do a couple more things with text and moving things around. This is specific to CS6, so CS5 might not actually be able to do this in the same way. Some things are missing from CS5.5. So in CS6, you can see this is where I've ended my project from before, and I can make these things invisible so you can see what I've done here. It's basically I've just copied this layer that was the total effects and removed the word effects. And before, I also removed this little bottle that was behind her head. In this case, what I want to do is actually work with this effects layer here. So what I'm going to do is the same thing I've done before. I'm going to highlight this total effects body wash thing, and I'm going to go to layer, new layer via copy. So if I make this piece invisible, you can see what's there. So I'll click on that layer. And what I'm going to do is try to remove the total effects body wash so you can see it really easily. I might just start with the total effects and then go into body wash later. The first thing I'm going to do actually is to just move it. And there's a couple ways to do things like this. You could always use your magic wand tool and you could zoom in really tightly here. And you could just highlight each thing. So I'm clicking once, then I'm holding on shift to add. And adding in the O and the T and the A and the L. Okay, that's great. Whatever. And then I might just move that stuff over. So I can click it and I can move it around. Now the problem is when you do that is that it tends to leave artifacts. So I'm going to make that invisible, move it again, and you can see that there's actually a little bit of black on the edges here. So I really don't want to do that. It's a clumsy way to do it, and it's the way that it used to be done in Photoshop. So instead, what I'm going to do is use this new tool, which is the Content Aware Move tool. And all you do here is you click and drag to highlight whatever it is you want to move. So I'm just going to move my total here. And then I'm just going to move it up. So you can see when I let go, it's going to actually try to fill in the background. And you can see it's not perfect here, which is why often I'll use the rubber stamp tool instead of using the Content Aware Move tool. But this often works very, very well if you're trying to just move a person slightly over in a beach scene or something like that. It doesn't always work well with text, with copy, unless you are on a solid background. It would work a little better on, for instance, it's or A, because all of this is the same color, than here where you've got this really strong gradient. Instead, what I'm going to show you how to do is this spot healing brush. So I'm going to undo my selection, and I'm just going to try to remove this T. And basically, it does a similar thing as the move tool. It looks at what's around it and it just tries to remove it out. And I'm just doing this multiple times to try to tell Photoshop that I don't actually want those pieces in. You'll notice that this is a little clumsier than the rubber stamp tool. But it also does allow you to duplicate things that are nearby, and in particular, it allows you to duplicate the grain of, in this case, the magazine paper. So it's not perfect, but it's pretty close. And you can see that here, where I had to blur it out, I've lost that grain. I'll have to add it back in later on. So that is one way to quickly and easily remove text. Again, if you are surrounded by a similar background, like just with this it's or whatever, it's actually very, very easy to use the Content Aware heal brush because it really does just remove stuff without any problems. If you're on a white background, it's incredibly simple to do that. It's when you've got gradients that it becomes a little bit more difficult. That's the easiest way to do it. To add text in, I would just click on my text tool and then just click here where I've got it. And I'm just going to type in, I'll type in total again. I can change my color by going to black. And so you can see here I've got, it's a little too big. So I'm going to click here and drag to maybe make this a little smaller, maybe a little more small here. So that's about right. I might make this stronger or bold or whatever I want to do. So bold condensed. No, it's not quite right. How about just bold? Bold's a little closer. So you can see you're really just playing back and forth to try to get it as close as possible. I'm not even bothering to change fonts here. I'm just getting as close as I can. But you can see that no matter how close you get, you're actually going to never match the existing font. Even if you find the same font in some cases, it's not going to match because of the printing process. So what you do is you remove all of the text, and then at the end, you just add the text back in. So I can always make this invisible, and I can make this other layer invisible, and I've got my original text here, this total. Now if I put this one back in, you can see the difference here. That's why you would normally remove all of the copy and then add copy back in. So that's it. Enjoy.